Now that we have studied the mirror function, reference geometries, and other common options like add relations, links below to all of those if you haven't watched them already, we can continue to expand our knowledge of SOLIDWORKS commands today with the sweep function. We'll work on two parts, the easy curl bar shown here, and another gym-related part, this multi-purpose pulley handle. The main difference between these two is that the curl bar has a sweep path that can be created in a 2D space, while the pulley handle has a sweep path that is only possible in a 3D space. So let's begin with the easy curl bar. From the front view, we can see that the bar is parallel to the front plane. So we'll begin here. And more importantly, since it's a symmetric geometry, we only need to build half of the bar and use the mirror feature at the end. For the bar itself, we can draw a sketch of its center line on the front plane, including the fillets, and then we can sweep that sketch, which we call path, with a second perpendicular sketch of a ring. After we have the bar, we add the plate section of the curl bar, and finally, we use the mirror option to create the second half. So let's begin by creating a sketch and selecting the front plane. We use the lines to do a rough sketch of the shape of the bar, and by using Smart Dimension, we set the horizontal lengths 85, 95, 85, 80, and 75, and the two vertical ones 50 and 95. We now use the Fillet option at the sketch level to set the rounded arcs to 50 for the left and the right fillets, and 15 for the interior ones. Worth mentioning here is that in some cases, you'll get a drawing that has diagonal lengths dimensioned, for example, a square root of 95 squared plus 50 squared, instead of the 50 and 95. In that case, you probably also have the angle for that diagonal line. Whatever the case is, you can dimension that in SOLIDWORKS with Smart Dimension. In other cases, the dimensions might be those of the segments without the fillets. For example, a length lower than 85 for the first segment. In that case, after creating the rough sketch, you would first do the fillets and then smart dimension the remaining segments. Notice that this first part of the sketch ends up being the same. With the sketch path completed, we exit the sketch. Now we need the sketch of a ring, which we will use to sweep that first sketch to create a cylinder in the shape of the bar. In a course like Mechanics of Materials, you'll learn why these circular cross-section structures are usually hollow. The additional material that would go in the middle wouldn't really resist the deflections or decrease the maximum stresses within the structure. We'll use the stress analysis tool in SOLIDWORKS later, so make sure to check out the link to that video in the description below. To do the ring, we'll use a plane that is perpendicular to either end of the path. Since the right plane meets that requirement, we'll select Sketch and select that plane. Now, the cross-section area we create does not need to be centered with the sketch that we will use as a path, meaning that the ring does not need to have its origin located at the endpoint of the first sketch. However, it can be, so we'll create it there. We'll draw two circles, we smart dimension them to 12 and 20 millimeters respectively, and we exit that second sketch. Now for the actual sweep function, we go into Features, we click on the Swept Boss Base button, and here we have to select two items. The first one, the profile we want to sweep with, in this case the sketch of the ring, and the second one, the path the sweep will follow, in this case our original sketch. Notice that the Sketch Profile option is selected, and if the preview looks okay, we click the green checkmark. Once that's done, we create an extrusion, located on the plane where the sweep ends, which consists of a circle of diameter 200 millimeters and a 60 millimeter thickness. Once the extrusion is done, we can select the chamfer option under the fillet feature command, and we set it to have a thickness of 10 millimeters and a 45 degree angle. Now that we have exactly half of the curl bar, we use the mirror function. We select the surface at the center of the bar and select all the features, and after checking that it looks good, we click OK. To finalize this part, we can maybe give it a good galvanized steel material to it. Easy, right? Now let's look at the other part we have for today, the pulley handle. Of course, this is a simplified version of the actual handle, but it's a good exercise to practice sweeps that use paths in 3D. The only difference here is that we need to create part of the sweep path on one plane and the second part of the path on a separate plane. Now those two planes aren't necessarily perpendicular. For example here, we want the second plane to be slanted 60 degrees with respect to the horizontal plane. Once the two sections of the sketch are done and connected, we will merge them using the composite curve option. So let's get to it. We create a sketch on the front plane. We create two lines here, and in this case, like I mentioned earlier, we are given the length of the diagonal line and the angle, as opposed to the horizontal and vertical components of the diagonal like before. Remember that to set the angle, we use Smart Dimension and click both lines. Now, before we run into a problem, let's point out something important. If we set this diagonal length to 5.2 inches and only leave the 4-inch segment for the second sketch on the second plane, we would be able to connect them, but we won't be able to assign that connection a fillet. SolidWorks would not understand that. For this reason, our approach will be to have a length shorter than 5.2, so that the second sketch is the remaining length going down, together with the 4-inch segment, so that we can actually add a fillet to that intersection point. To make this easy, we will split that length in two halves, 2.6 inches on one sketch, and the other 2.6 inches in the second sketch. For the second sketch, we want to use a plane that is parallel and coincident to the two lines we want to create, to, you know, be able to create those two lines. There's no unique way to do this, but since we already know from the reference geometries video, link below, that we can create a reference plane that is perpendicular to a segment, we will create a construction line within this sketch that is perpendicular to the diagonal segment. This way, the reference plane that is perpendicular to the segment that is already perpendicular to the line we want will be parallel to that line. You'll understand it better when we're doing it. Within this sketch, we create a construction line segment that is perpendicular to the diagonal segment. We go into Reference Geometries and select the reference plane. We select the construction line and set the plane to be perpendicular to it. And as the second reference, we select the endpoint of our first sketch, not the end of the construction line though, so that this reference plane is parallel to the diagonal and touching the endpoint that we want to use to continue the path. We create a sketch composed of two perpendicular lines, one equaling length to the remaining 2.6 inches, and the other one equal to 4 inches. We set the fillet to be 0.5 inches, and here's what we'll do to connect the endpoints. We go into Add Relations and select the endpoint of this current sketch, and since the endpoint of the previous sketch is within Sketch 1, not the current sketch, we can only select the line, not the point. Not to worry, with these two entities selected, we choose the Pierce Add Relation option, and this is exactly what we wanted. Even though they are now connected, we can't go to sweep yet, cause the sweep function will only allow us to select one sketch as the path. To merge these two sketches into one path, we go into Insert, then into Curve, then into Composite, and we select the two sketches to create a composite of both. This composite curve is what we'll use as the path for our sweep. The other sketch we need is the profile we'll sweep. In this case, it's just a circle, not a ring. We go into a plane that is perpendicular to the beginning of our path, in this case the right plane will work, and we draw a circle of 0.5 inches diameter in it. And now we can create the sweep. We go into Features, Sweep, select the circle as the profile and the composite curve as the path, and we click OK. We add a circular extrusion next to our origin, 1 inch in diameter, half the length it needs to be, meaning 0.4 inches, and now we have exactly half of our part. We use the mirror command, we select the mirroring face, the parts we want to mirror, and in this case we check geometry pattern to prevent SolidWorks from having an issue about mirroring a sweep that is not connected to the extrusion. And we're done! If any of the steps that were performed without much explanation were hard to follow, make sure you've watched all of the previous 8-minute videos up to this point. You'll find descriptive titles and links to the other videos of the SolidWorks series, as well as other engineering courses in the description below, so make sure to check those out. Thanks for watching!